admit it, if you have somebody to make you chicken soup and give you tissues, having a cold is almost a little bit fun. Like, yeah, you're sick, but you don't have to go to work and you can just sleep all day or watch Sherlock. You're on your own, though. You still have all the mucus and the headaches, but no extra pampering, so being sick just sucks. A new study published in the journal Health Psychology has even found scientific evidence of this. It turns out being lonely can actually make a cold feel worse. To kick off the experiment, 213 volunteers answered a bunch of questions to measure how lonely they felt and how strong their social networks were. Basically, how many connections they had with family, friends, coworkers, and everyone else they might interact with in a typical week. Then, researchers used nasal drops to expose them to a strain of rhinovirus, the culprit behind the common cold. The participants stayed in quarantine for 5 days, where they reported their symptoms daily using a scoring system that's standard for these kinds of studies. They rated how bad they felt on a scale of 0 to 4. After the researchers statistically analyzed all of the data, they found that loneliness and social ties did not seem to affect how likely someone was to get sick after squirting viruses up their nose. But feeling lonely was a strong predictor of how bad people's self-reported cold symptoms were, even after accounting for a whole bunch of things like age, sex, education, level, income, marriage, body mass, and even the time of the year. The actual size of people's social networks measured by the survey they took didn't have this effect. Only how lonely they felt seemed to matter. In other words, your perception of loneliness can impact how crappy you feel during a cold, regardless of how many friends you actually have. So the psychological toll of social isolation can have some serious physical effects. Past studies have suggested that it can increase your risk of heart disease, for instance, and might even worsen the effects of breast cancer. And the researchers suggest that this is more evidence that doctors need to consider their patients' emotional well-being, not just their vital signs, to really understand sickness. Meanwhile, in Utah, some animals probably felt pretty great when tons of food appeared out of nowhere in their backyard. And the scientists that left the treats got a surprising new peek into American badger behavior, which they reported in a paper published this week. Bird researchers from the University of Utah were hoping to learn more about vultures and other scavengers, so they set out 7 baby cow carcasses in the mountains west of Salt Lake City. Animals would visit the tasty decomposing meat, and motion-activated cameras automatically snapped photos of them. That way, the scientists could download the image files and see what kinds of scavengers turned up. At least that was the plan. But when a student went back to check on the carcasses a week after they were set out, one had gone missing. At first, he was bummed because he thought a large predator had dragged it away from the cameras, which wouldn't be that great for the study, but then he noticed that the dirt was all dug up. And the photos from the camera trap revealed the real culprit. A badger had dug a pit under the dead calf and then buried the entire thing over the course of 5 days. That same badger then spent weeks visiting the site, feasting on aged veal tartare. And a second badger partially buried another calf carcass nearby. So this wasn't just one weirdly creative animal. It looks like it could be pretty normal badger behavior. So when an American badger is hungry, it will bury a whole dang cow. We already knew that badgers like to cache or bury smaller food like rabbits. Caching keeps the meat cool so it stays fresh longer, and it keeps other hungry animals from finding it. But this is the first time anyone has observed badgers burying animals bigger than themselves that they can't like drag around. In the tough environment of the Great Basin Desert, this behavior could have a big ecological impact. Normally, a large carcass would be a feast for a whole range of scavengers, from vultures to coyotes. But if American badgers are hiding these hunks of meat and monopolizing them, like any good American, then that resource isn't available to other animals. And that's a big deal for an ecosystem where food can be hard to come by. Not only that, but badgers could unintentionally be helping out ranchers by burying dead cattle. This could keep the carcasses from spreading disease or attracting predators that might attack other cows in the herd. So while bigger is usually better when it comes to sample size in research papers, even 2 little badgers showed that there is a lot we have to learn about animal behavior, even right here in America. If you'd like to learn more about human behavior, or more ways that your mind can affect your body, you should check out our new channel, which we have, SciShow Psychology, at youtube.com/scishowpsych. And don't forget to go to youtube.com/scishow and subscribe for more of this.